Okay, so today we are going to learn how to build diagrams of beams, diagrams of shear force and bending moment for beams with distributed loads. First of all, let us make a review of the distributed loads. For beams, we may have two main types of distributed loads. The uniformly distributed load, this one is uniform, same value in all the distance of the load. This is called uniform load, distributed load. And then we have another one that is a linear load. For instance, in a beam like this, we may have something like this. There's a linear variation. Here the value is zero, and here we may have a value, final value. This is a linear one. Since we are going to use the graphic method, to build those diagrams, we're only going to use this one, this type of load. For this one, we may not apply the graphic method because it involves a higher order, like in the shear diagram, we will have like a parabola or a quadratic equation. And in order to find the area, at the end of the day, we need to find an integral. And we don't want to solve integrals, but only areas. Simple areas like rectangles or trapezoids, okay? So let us deal with this type of load. And how is this load measured? W might be indicated in kilonewtons per meter, in pounds per foot, or kilopounds, keep per foot. Or if we use the Mexican system that some professors, colleagues, they like, is the kilograms per meter. And from these kilograms, we may get also tons per meter. Okay. What are we going to do today? We are going to use this one. But this order, this is the imperial system, This is the MKS. I like the international system. If you go to Italy, you go to France, you go to Spain, you go to the UK, you go to Australia, you go to Japan, they all use the international system. That's why I prefer this one over this one, but no problem with that one as well, okay? So let us solve something. But what is it telling you, the unit? It means that per every meter, for instance, if this is 1 meter, you will have certain amount of kilonewtons, okay? So in total, if you have, for instance, 5 meters, the total load will be the area of this rectangle, okay? So this is just a small or short review. Of distributed loads. For instance, if I have that beam, I have here a rectangle. This distributed, uniformly distributed load is a rectangle like this. We can easily find that this is a rectangle. So I ask you, where is the centroid of that rectangle? Where is the centroid of a rectangle? That's a simple question.
In the middle.
Huh?
In the middle.
Yes. There. More or less, no? If that's the, if this is L, then we get here L divided by 2 and L divided by 2. And here we could put an equivalent load. I'm going to put it in another color. Of how much? The area. What is the area if this value is W, this constant? The equivalent load is W times L, okay? And we need to do that. When we are finding reactions. And remember, the first step was finding reactions. Do you remember? For the graphic method. So we are finding reactions and we have a distributed load. First, we need to put it as a concentrated load, equivalent one, but just for reactions, only for reactions. Somebody may ask, what happens with a linear load? For instance, a triangular one. Although we are not going to solve beams with triangular loads now, the diagrams, you need to know where the centroid of a triangle is. The centroid of a triangle, it is well known that it is, or is the most, you can demonstrate that it is, but I'm not going to do it now. Is located like this. It is at 1/3 or 2/3 from this side, 2L divided by 3. Está a 1/3 de su altura máxima. Aquí, o a 2/3. I'm going to draw the rectangle. The centroid is here. And what is the value of this concentrated load? Is the value of the area. What is the area of this triangle? You remember the formula from primary school, area of a triangle?
Base por altura entre dos.
What is the base in this case?
L.
Times?
W.
Divided by 2. So therefore, this is what we put here. As a concentrated load. And only for reactions, okay? So with that in mind, let us solve now an example of a diagram of beams with distributed loads, okay? I'm going to draw a line here to indicate that we go now to the example. Imagine we have this, oh, sorry. My pulse on Monday morning is like, we can pulse. When you have this beam, the simplest one, and I have 20 kilonewtons per meter in a span, or claro, L equals 5 meters. I need to know first the reactions, and B, diagrams for V and M. So, first step, reactions. What did I tell you now? I have a distributed load. What do I need to do with that distributed loading? I need to replace it with a concentrated load. What is the value of that concentrated load? What is the area of this rectangle?
Base por altura.
Yeah.
100.
Por los
100 kilonewtons. And it's located where? You agree?
Yes.
Now we place the reactions. Here we have the AY, this is A, and this is B. And here we get the BY. I can write the equations of equilibrium to find the reaction. The first one I like to use is the moment one, to already find one. And let's do it in B now for a change. So if I'm here, what sort of moment is AY doing with respect to B? Positive or negative? This one.
Negative.
Negative.
Times 5. From here to here is 5 meters. Then we get this one doing a moment like this with respect to B. And according to my convention, that's positive. You agree?
Yes.
Equals 0. Okay. There's nothing else because this one passes through B, is not producing moment. Therefore, I get this. I pass this to the other side with a change of sign, and I get AY equals what? You agree? Just by inspection, by looking at this drawing, this one, you can see that there's symmetry. Immediately, you should think that the value of AY should be equal to BY. There's symmetry. You agree? So we got 50. What should we expect for BY? What value? Sorry. The same value, okay? That's what we should expect. Now we have the reactions. We are ready to build the diagram. Any questions up to here?
No.
Okay. Now, what was the first step after the reactions? The next one. We need to make the axis like this one. Now, I have a value of AY of 50. I start at 0, and then I go up 50, the value of AY. Yeah, 50. Here, 50. Now, the distributed load, this one, is telling me that I go down 20 for every meter that I advance. How many meters I'm going to advance from A to B, to the end of the load? 5 meters. So if I am going down 20 for each meter and I advance 5, how much in total I'm going down?
100.
100. But I'm plus 50. And if I go down minus 100, I get to where? To minus 50. Something like that. And then this should be the value of the reaction BY, 50. Yes. And this is my shear force diagram. Okay. I have a positive area, negative area. And obviously this thing is going to be in the middle. Any questions?
No.
What was the next step to find now the value or the diagram of M? I need what? Areas. Okay. What is the value of this area one?
Base por altura sobre dos, ¿no?
Yes. So how much it is? Okay. Now, since this is linear, you see this is una linea recta, a straight line, the moment will have to be a parabola, a quadratic equation. I'm going to put it in another color. And I get to the value of 62.5 kilonewtons per meter. Now, this area is exactly the same. Area two, 2.5 times minus 50 divided by two is minus 62.5. And I'm 62.5 minus 62.5, I get to zero. And this is my bending moment diagram M. With this maximum value. Any questions? I'm going to put a note here. This note is saying, since V is una línea recta con pendiente, it's a straight line with a slope, M, moment, has to be quadratic because the moment is always one order above the shear force, okay? Es un orden superior, el momento. Sí, ya que el cortante es de primer orden, es una línea recta con pendiente, el momento tiene que ser, cuando hay cargas distribuidas uniformes, una parábola cuadrática. When we have distributed loads like this one, that are uniform, the shear force is always going to be like this, an inclined straight line, and the bending moment is going to be a quadratic parabola, okay? Like this. Any questions? This is the main difference before with the concentrated loads. We have now not constant shear values, but a linear distribution of shear force with equation of straight line And the moment is a quadratic equation. Questions? Everything clear in this? In this example?
Hey.
Okay. Now I stop this video and we go to another example in Spanish.